Yeah.
It's a political party. When a friend of mine decided he was going to run for mayor of Portland, I said, okay, what can we do? What can we do? And me and my man, Matey, we sat down one day and said, let's do a party. And this is Jefferson Smith, who is running for mayor, and he's coming up, and he's going to say something to you that probably nobody else here can say, because he has an incredible way of saying things that he says.
Come out, so he said, how does it feel like to be the underdog? And I said, I don't know, you know, why am I the underdog? I'm taller than the other candidates. And afterwards, my wife was driving me home, and I must have looked kind of down, because she said, screw it. Just work your ass off and tell the truth. And it was the most important moment of the campaign. And after that, we started trying to be a little clearer about some of the things that are happening in our community. A little bit clearer about the fact that the biggest transportation infrastructure project in the history of our region is the highway interchange project in Vancouver, so people living in Clark County can avoid Oregon income taxes and Oregon land use laws. And by the way, the impact it'll have on our part of town will be increasing asthma rates in inner north and northeast Portland. And I know who lives there. And they're not the people who are going to be building big mansions in Clark County. And I looked at graduation rates in our town, and I realized they weren't near what they should be. But I looked at the graduation rates of white kids, and they were just as good as the graduation of white kids across the country. But graduation of kids in our town who aren't white kids, not nearly as good as the graduation rates of kids around the country. And I looked in my own legislative district, and I saw as 27% of the population is living east of 82nd Avenue. But only 1.5% of the stimulus dollars were spent there, only 3.3% of the transportation dollars, when $11 million were spent on subsidized loans for energy retrofits, zero to Park Row, zero to Reynolds, zero to David Douglas, zero to Centennial. That's a third or more of the students in our city, and they weren't even asked to apply. But now our city is facing a different set of questions. And one of the most important questions we're facing is if this town can be as strong as I think we can be as our city is changing the way it is. See, in my part of town, in my school district, we got 80% of the kids on free or reduced price lunch. They speak 73 languages. They reflect the future of our city. In fact, the students in our city will soon be majority non-white. That's the future of Portland, Oregon. And if we don't figure out how to be stronger together than we are apart, if we don't figure out how to make the growing diversity in our town be a strength, this city won't be nearly as strong as it should and can be. I want to say some thank yous, and for those, I want to make sure at least I don't miss some very important names. We can give a big, loud yell and applause at the end for Noah and Kenny and Matey and Monique and Marisol and Jim O'Connor and Andy and S2O and Peter McGovern. Give a round of applause.
Want to win.
Get up, stand up. 503 TV.